talking about the baptismal font. The baptismal font is an actual vessel where the water of baptism is poured or contained. It is the spiritual womb where the believers take birth. It reminds us about the act of saving through the crucifixion of Jesus. Baptism is done in front of the Mother Bahá'í, the holy center. The baptismal font is located at the entrance of the church. This is because the font logically follows a theological principle where in its placement it meets the needs of the sacrament and indicates the nature of baptism as the entry of the church and is celebrated by the whole Christian community. Now let us talk about the Mother Bahá'í. The Mother Bahá'í is a place of sacrifice. It is sacred and holy. It is generally located on the eastern side of church. Now the Mother Bahá'í is the sanctum sanctorum, which means the holy of holies of the church. It is the symbol of heaven and the center of worship. It is a worldly sanctuary where believers are drawn to a heavenly experience in the presence of God the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, along with innumerable number of angels. Now the Mother Bahá'í reminds us of the divine presence of God, and it is set apart specifically to celebrate the liturgy. The Mother Bahá'í is a Syriac word which is separated by a curtain from the Haikala, which is also a Syriac word which means the congregation hall. This is to signify that the Mother Bahá'í is different and is not to be treated as the Haikala. The cross, as a symbol of the risen Christ, is kept inside the Mother Bahá'í. Now let us discuss the chancel. The chancel or the Arikakam is a part of the church just below the Mother Bahá'í and the rails. This place is used for general prayers during sacraments, wedding, baptismal ceremonies and other such services. Those who come for the Thanksgiving prayer and those who participate in the Holy Communion kneel down here to receive the blessings and Holy Kurbana respectively. Another place is the nave or the Haikala, which literally means the sanctuary. It is also called the Pragara. It is the main congregation of in the eastern tradition, the congregation is stood throughout the worship. Now there are benches provided in most places. There is also the portico. It is the portion behind the main hall called the Pumukham or the vestibule, and it is an appendix to the main building. This was a place used by catechumens during the early church period to stage cultural programs. It is not necessarily found these days. The eastern churches are generally constructed towards the east-west direction, and worship is done facing the Mother Bahá'í in the east. The primary reasons for this is because God in the Bible is referred to as the Son of Righteousness, and the sun rises in the east, and that is why this is the direction chosen for worship. The Garden of God's Presence is also believed to be in the east. Moreover, the glorious second coming of Jesus Christ will also be from the east. Thus, during the Holy Communion service, the entire congregation, including the bishop, the priest, and the deacon, face the east in unison and look towards God. Now let us direct our attention to the Tirachila. The Tirachila is the cross in the middle, separating the sanctuary and the Haikala, symbolically representing the sky that separates the heaven and earth. The Mother Bahá'í signifies heaven, and the Haikala, which is the congregation hall, signifies earth. The curtain is drawn from right to left during the Holy Communion and other sacraments. When the Tirachila opens, we are reminded that we can directly go into the presence of God and the throne of God. Through the grace, through the death of Jesus Christ, we do not need any mediators. God has torn the veil. We can approach Him directly with our concerns. Also represents the mystery of salvation that is revealed to all of us. Thus, the Tirachila has been used in both the Old Testament and the New Testament. This has influenced Christian churches to have curtains in all their sanctuaries.